Hello and welcome to Chemistry in Your Cupboard. I'm Jo, an Education Coordinator at the Royal Society of Chemistry, and today we're going to try and fool one of our senses. Humans have five senses: sight, sound, smell, touch, and taste. And today we're going to try and fool our sense of taste. You can try this experiment with a responsible adult. So let's get started.
For this, you'll need a glass of orange juice, a mirror, your toothbrush, your normal toothpaste, and yourself to test this out on.
Have you ever noticed that when you've brushed your teeth and then have a drink of orange juice, oh, it tastes really weird. It's so bitter. What on earth is going on? Have you ever taken a look at the surface of your tongue? Grab the mirror and take a look. Can you see those little bumps on there? We have between 200 and 400 of those little bumps, and the scientific name for them is fungiform papillae. And on those little bumps, we have between 2,000 and 8,000 taste buds, but they're so small, we can't see them in the mirror. And those taste buds help us to detect the five flavours: salty, sour, sweet, bitter, and umami. Umami is a very savoury flavour, found in foods such as soy sauce, Parmesan cheese, and yeast extract. Here's a very basic model of the surface of your tongue. You can think of different tastes as being a bit like different shapes, and each taste bud is designed to recognise different shapes and reject others. So let's pretend we're eating an apple. Your mouth is flooded with sweet and sour tastes, which attach to their correct shape and sends a signal to your brain. This sorting system is usually really accurate, but sometimes you can play a trick on it. Toothpaste is made up of four main ingredients: water, abrasives that remove bacteria from the surface of your teeth and gums, fluoride, which helps fight cavities, the tiny holes that can appear on the teeth if you don't brush well, and detergents, which create the foam, evenly distributing the toothpaste inside your mouth. A common ingredient is sodium lauryl sulfate, and it's used in many other household products where producing a foam is necessary. It's great at being foamy, but it fools around with our sense of taste. Is sodium lauryl sulfate listed as an ingredient on your shampoo or liquid soap? Go and take a look, I bet it is. And this is the model of sodium lauryl sulfate. It's like a long snake, and being long and slithery is what makes it great at being foamy. It can be used to explain how substances like these are used in washing up liquids, where you're removing oily food from your plates. This bit loves water, and this bit loves oil. So when more of them gather together, the oil gathers with them and it's removed from your dishes, making them clean and sparkling. So what's all that got to do with fooling your sense of taste? The sodium lauryl sulfate attaches to the bits of our tongue that recognise sweet things, and therefore blocks the sweet substances from being able to attach. It also destroys something in our mouths that stops really bitter things from tasting bitter. So it's no wonder orange juice tastes so horrible after brushing your teeth. It creates a double whammy of bitterness. You can try this experiment with a responsible adult. Just remember, never eat soap and shampoo, and always use the correct amount of toothpaste when you brush your teeth twice a day.
And that's how we can easily fool our sense of taste. Does your toothpaste contain sodium lauryl sulfate? If you use a different toothpaste to an adult in your house, are the ingredients any different? What happens if you drink apple juice or fruit squash after you've brushed? Do they taste weird too? And how long does it take after you brush your teeth for orange juice to go back to tasting normal?
Let us know and share your results using the hashtag #ChemistryInYourCupboard. We'll be back soon, but in the meantime, please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Chemistry in Your Cupboard videos. See you soon.